All right, so this is going to be a subscriber analysis for my subscriber Kiki, a.k.a. Cholo Soccer Mom, against Terrence, the Falco player from Hawaii, I guess. This is from the Hawaii SSBM Twitch page. This is Falco versus Fox, but we are doing this from the Fox perspective. And I want to talk about the stages, first of all. That's normally something I like to do. And you guys struck to FD, which is abnormal. Normally, one or the other thinks that it's a very good counterpick for the other. Maybe you guys just both thought that this was a good stage for you, so you ended up here. Usually the way it goes is that you will ban Battlefield. They'll take off Yoshi's and FD, or FOD and FD most of the time, and then you either pick between Dreamland and Yoshi's. Dreamland and Yoshi's is very, very obviously the general starter in this matchup. But FD, I would say, is really good for you as Fox. I think this is Fox's best stage in the matchup, but you have to be able to do some certain things in the matchup to make this so good for you. Abusing full hop approaches and mixing up your aerial drifts and fastfall timings is one of those things. Another thing is how you respect lasers, how you give and take space. When you take laser, like take laser dashback, take laser full hop, take laser turnaround up tilt, I hope to see some of those things. And also have a strong punish game on this stage, because you might not win 100% of the neutral interactions, but every neutral interaction that you win has the potential to turn into a stock on this stage, which is normally not the case on any other stage. So, we're going to dive in and kind of see what happens. So it starts off with a laser, and the first thing that I'm seeing right here, and I know this is just right off the bat, but I don't like seeing this double, like this full hop double jump right here. This kind of looks like you're a little uncomfortable with how things should go, but he also doesn't seem to be forcing an aggressive mix-up in the corner. So he's playing decently patient right now, shooting a lot of lasers. You ran under and took center stage, which is not a bad thing. You also attempted, well, you didn't run under, he did a nair, you rolled into center stage, but he overcommitted this nair into the corner, and I like that you actually just went and took center stage. Having center stage in this matchup is very, very good for you. You back up a little far. You really need to pay attention to threat ranges in this matchup, and especially if you have Falco in the corner, I want you moving forward at him in the corner. One shine in the corner, one nair shine, catching him in the air for trying to do a laser, one full hop nair into the corner, into a shine or something, can mean just a full stock for you. One power shield nair, power shield grab into the corner, all those things are really, really good. But if you give up this space right here, you can't hit him with anything meaningful, right? But he can hit you with a projectile that has stun on it. So you're giving up all that space for no reason. You have to keep it close as Fox. You have to be outside the initial just drift forward aerial range from Falco, but also close enough so that you can do things like dash up smash, or short hop nair at him. Because your effective threat range with your dash is slightly larger than Falco's, but he has a projectile, so as soon as you leave your initial threat range, you enter his, because now he has a projectile. And eventually you went into the corner regardless. And I gotta see you be a little bit more comfortable on the ground. I'm seeing a lot of these full hop double jumps. And that's normally just stemming from the fact that you don't want to be on the ground. But don't be afraid of these lasers. Take the lasers and then move out of them. You see how you took a laser and then shielded right here? I gotta see you move out of them. And it can't always be full hop. And it seems like it's almost always full hop right now. Try to wave dash out of shield more often. Try to dash forward and dash back after shielding a laser a little bit more. Or after taking a laser a little bit more often. But if you're shielding, it's just like you're gonna get stuck. Could have seen a little bit cleaner play off the ledge right there. Kind of unfortunate. Not a great edge guard from him either. And this is the exact problem that we were seeing before, right? And this is just lack of comfort on the ground. A full hop, you didn't want to land on the laser. You double jump, and then you just come down with an aerial, and he's just waiting for you right there. Try to stay on the ground. Take laser, dash forward up smash. Take laser, dash forward nair. Running shine immediately on wake up. Stuff like that is really, really effective against Falco. I like the pressure in the corner. He rolls out, doesn't really get anything for it. This is good. Again, there was a little bit of hesitation right here, too. This drill shine was fantastic. I love it. But then there was this full hop for... Was it a short hop or a full hop? This essentially happened for no reason. That full hop right there. That might have just been a missed wave dash, but that can't happen. Like, this is your big moment. We have him on the ground. You were just barely a little bit late. Spot dodge shine got you. If you do something like this full hop, you should know that you're not going to get here in time, and you should bait out either a turnaround up tilt, a get up attack, or a spot dodge. All of those things are all easily whiff punishable with the same timing. Up tilt and spot dodge almost have the exact same frame data in terms of the total frame amount. I think they're like 2 frames different or something. So if you whiff punish the up tilt, you're also waiting for the spot dodge at the same time. Same thing with get up attack. He kicks in front of him, starting frame 17, which is very similar to the timing of whiff punishing an up tilt or a spot dodge, which are really, really common wake up options from Falco. Could have seen some better DI here on these combos, but not the worst. Looks like he caught your roll with that grab. So don't be afraid of trying to sweet spot this this side B right here. Early side Bs are an easy way to just give your opponent a solid punish and potentially a kill. So I like that you're doing the full hop now that he's a little closer, but again, you're most of the time just shielding after lasers. Imagine right here, just imagine with me for a second, you take that laser and you dash back, and now you're just in center stage again, right? And if he does a short hop aerial at you, free whiff punish, right? And he didn't do that drift forward aerial, but all he did was a jab. Like, you lose nothing by dashing back because you have all the stage to work with. So try not to keep yourself locked in shield like this so often, because it's happening a lot. Nice. Up tilt. Ooh, you definitely have to look for those up tilts at those higher percents when they do either slight DIs or just straight DI. Because if they DI away, then you can re-grab for longer. I'm sure that you know that. But up tilting is really important as a part of the combo extension. You can also up throw fair tech chase. Not a terrible ledge dash, but also not the cleanest thing I've ever seen. I'm just liking that you did it. Full hop bear execution test in the corner seemed to work out for you pretty well. Nice. You're on the ledge. Re-grab. Not a bad ledge dash. You waited too long on the ledge for this to be insanely effective, but you actually went for it, which was good. But since you waited so long, you didn't have a lot of invincibility, and then you just ledge dash shielded. Instead of doing something like ledge dash up smash right here, which would have just straight up killed him because he's at 105. So he should definitely not be messing with you in the corner right here as long as you can actually do the execution correctly. Okay, so this is something kind of interesting. If somebody does roll over 100, it's so hard to distinguish from regular get up and get up attack right here, and they actually have invulnerability up until like this point right here. So if you up smash this area, you just straight up won't hit them. You see how that works? They just roll right past you. So it's almost like a 50-50 from that point. There's probably a couple things that you can do to cover it. I can't think of many things right now. But there are certain ranges you could probably forward smash at, but you kind of have to read that situation, which is kind of a bummer, but yeah, that's just a thing. And since you overcommitted into the corner and he got, he was correct on the read right there, he got a little bit of a punish on you. And here you are off the stage. You definitely could have teched that. Definitely could have teched it. You had a little reaction on the webcam too. I know that people can't see that in the video, but it seemed like you knew that you could have teched it. That's okay. Nice. So there it was again. This is the over 100 roll from the ledge. You see how similar it looks to regular getup? How are you supposed to know at that point right there? He rolls past you, but you grab him, which is nice. Up throw, up air. Solid. I like it. Put the pressure on him. He was flubbing some execution. It was good. So again, this is your biggest problem, Kiki. Literally your biggest problem is you just try to power shield these lasers. It almost never works. And the problem is, you're either power shielding the laser or taking the laser and then shielding, both of which are not great, unless you're actually hitting the power shield. You're getting this light shield here, and one thing that could help you to help power shield lasers, because you can't power shield with the light shield, is actually just full press your trigger down when you plug in your controller so that you only have hard press. It makes it a lot easier to power shield, I promise you. So try that out. But if you hit the power shield, great. If not, you're kind of in a pretty bad position, right? And you're also not wave dashing at a shield effectively, and also not doing aerials at a shield effectively to make this worthwhile to go for. But yeah, I would have really liked to see you even just take the laser. You have to think about it. It's like a 3% little thing that hits you, and it does the same amount of stun as it would do on your shield. So taking lasers is actually really, really good. And then there's that full hop double jump again. Full hop double jump again. Full hop. Like, think about just doing short hop approaches, staying on him a little bit more often. That's what Mango does in this matchup when he plays it. He stays on top of the Falco all the time so that he can't get those lasers out, especially on a stage like this where those lasers can be so deadly. And this is what I was talking about, how on this stage, like, if you struck here as the Fox, it should be really good for you, but if you're not utilizing all of your tools correctly, it can be pretty punishing because the Falco just controls everything so well. So it's kind of a scrappy situation, not a lot to say about it. Up there right there, and then a missed conversion. Your punishes could definitely be so much cleaner. I'm assuming that was a missed jump cancel up smash, so there's not a ton to say about it. Okay, he STIs out of that. Also wasn't the best drift by you, but that's okay. Nice grab on the back air. I really, really like that. You also could have just straight up done an up smash out of shield right here. Just keep that in mind. It's a little bit more guaranteed than that up throw up air. But that was good. All in all, you probably dropped like three or four neutral openings that turned into conversions that could have really hurt him. But you cleaned up the stock eventually, which isn't terrible. So here you are, you're almost exclusively doing these full hop approaches, and he's being so patient and just shooting so many lasers and waiting that most of the time it's not working out for you that often. He's using a lot of up tilts, a lot of stuff like that. Just barely misspaced here. That's a little unfortunate. But think about just do run-up up smashes and running shines against Falco. Like, it might seem kind of scary, but they're really, really important timing mix-ups to threaten. Again, there's that full hop double jump out of shield. Literally learn how to wave dash out of shield. It will make you so much more mobile. Imagine at this point where you full hopped out of shield, imagine if you wave dash forward. You wave dash forward and then run under him, take center stage, or wave dash under him and then up tilt. It'd be amazing. You're losing so much by not wave dashing out of shield. Again, full hop double jump out of shield. This is the biggest thing, Kiki, by far. If you fix this and just mixed up what you're doing out of shield, or power shielding the lasers more consistently, or doing take laser options, like take laser turnaround up tilt, take laser full hop, take laser dash back, or take laser dash forward. Ooh, man, that would have been such a different game. If literally just the shield interaction with the lasers, if you had done what I'm talking about, you probably would have two-stocked him, even with your like, not fantastic punishes. So just keep that in mind. It is so important. Watch Leffen, Crush, and KJH specifically against Falcos, and you'll see how they deal with lasers so effectively. It's really, really, really good. And you'll see how even on FD they're not just spamming the full hop double jump with like a drift forward trying to hit them desperately. Okay, so you're in the corner here, which is okay because he just rolled to take center. Tried to full hop out, a bit of a tech flip there, not a lot to analyze. Back throw, I'm really glad that you're grabbing the auto cancel back here still. That was good. Mm-hmm. Kind of a wonky up air, you could have converted a little bit harder than that, but I think you needed a read on the top platform regardless. Yeah, you did. So that's okay. Top platform position, I really would have liked to see you not just drop through immediately. Maybe just like wave dash off or just like short hop back to the side platform and just like move around a little bit. Maybe reposition yourself back to the ground. Or like wave dash down and then short hop off and then fall through the side platform and do a back air. That would be something that's really, really good too. But this shield drop down air wasn't going to hit anybody, and it also wouldn't have really converted to anything regardless. Because you probably would have caught him jumping towards center stage anyway with like a short hop laser and aerial, and then if you drill him in the air he can probably shine you out first anyway. Kind of some weird jabs, but jab grab in the end, not a terrible option. Execution tested him right there. It was successful. He did not do a good stall, and you forward tilted him for it. That was good. Messing with his invincibility, this is something that I always tell people not to do. You were just a little miscalculated. I think you did shield on the top platform, which isn't bad. To get away from him, but just really take invincibility seriously and either go to the ledge or light shield on a side platform, or like go to center stage and try like a dash wave dash mix up. Be careful here too. You get shined up here and you double jump immediately out of hit stun, then try to come down with an aerial. You could have drifted back to the ledge right here, which would have been probably your best bet, as long as you were confident with your ledge options. And I've seen you ledge dash a couple times. I know you could do it. Ooh, good angle. Good up tilt from him, though. Not a terrible side B, but just remember that like this could have been punished pretty solidly. Again, he could have even just punished your landing right here, even with his laser timings. I'm pretty sure if he just fast fallen slightly sooner on reaction to you being down there. See, and now you go to the ledge. This is kind of interesting to me. I guess what happened here is you tried to commit to a short hop nair into the corner, and then it just he rolled past you. Until you went to the edge. I don't mind this, but it's just kind of interesting that like you avoided going to the ledge and spammed early double jump before, but now that was like your comfort pick. So this was a solid ledge dash. This is a very solid ledge dash. Again, look at this. You're waiting. This is what I'm talking about, is that you're waiting here. This is called cliff wait. You're waiting in cliff wait too long and using all of your invincibility frames up. Right there. See, you waited probably right there, probably like 5 extra frames on the ledge, I would say, when you actually did the ledge dash. It's not that one, it's this one. Yep. At least 5 extra frames. At least. So your ledge dash was probably only like a 6-frame ledge dash, I would say. Maybe even less. But you shouldn't be doing things like ledge dash shield and ledge dash roll if you don't have to. You know, if you could do ledge dash dash nair, ledge dash full hop, ledge dash up smash, ledge dash jab, ledge dash dash back, all those things are so effective, and the mix-ups between all of them is so hard to read as the Falco that he's gonna get punished pretty hard eventually. So he overcommits right here, and he falls right into your full hop in the corner, which is pretty solid. Not the best punish I've seen. The side platform's at a pretty weird height. Yeah, nice. Side platform being a weird height pretty helped you out quite a bit, and also he just did an early side B and you punished him for it. That was a very solid read. You go to the ledge. This is exactly what I was talking about. Instead of messing with the invincibility, you go straight to the ledge. I like this a lot. Looks like you flubbed though, which is kind of unfortunate. Laser jab forward tilt. Good angle again. He was nowhere to be seen. Side B off the ledge, not the worst thing in the world. You're at like 160. But something you can do actually that's a little bit more tricky than just immediate side B right here is you can double jump, fast fall, and then side B, which is a timing mix-up that a lot of people just aren't used to. You'll catch a lot of people off guard with that. If you watch Lucky, he does it pretty frequently. So this is a perfect time where you can start approaching with just up smashes. You can beat out Falco so easily with up smashes, especially when these side platforms are at such weird heights. You could just catch him out and then turn that into a huge combo for you, only because those side platforms are so low. But I mean, you can do it on regular stages too. It's just like there's a little bit more threat of you being hit. It just lines up so well with these platform heights, especially this one over here, because he can't do any aerials. He can't do any aerials or shoot any lasers at the side platform height over here. He's just gonna land on the side platform when he tries to do it. So if you just run up, all of your like your running up smash is gonna be all of his grounded options by a lot. So now that you have some platforms to work with, instead of doing the full hop double jumps, you're full hopping and then landing on the side platforms, which I like quite a bit, but it just shows you how uncomfortable you were on FD. Not a terrible attempt at that, the full hop back air. Nice. Pressure on wake up. Nice. Catching his early side Bs. These early side Bs, like the thing is, this down smash was good against him because he has shown you already that he's going to be doing these early side Bs. Just be careful because some people are going to up B a little bit more often. People are going to hit their shortens when they get better. They're going to sweet spot the edge. I actually don't think that Falco can sweet spot his down smash underneath Fox's down smash, but he can at least tech side B or tech waveland. So yeah, just be a little bit careful as people get better. You can't only do the down smashes when they're doing the early side B or like sweet spotted side Bs like that. Run up smash him right now. It would be amazing. Oh my god. Yeah, you definitely. If you watch Leffen, just watch Leffen. He is the best in the world by far at it. Like, watch his West Ball sets and how he just does run up smash against Falco. It is so good, I promise you. Just watch the spaces he does it. Also, just hold away during the down throw. You can actually react to the down throw happening and then just SDI away those lasers, and you won't get hit by that down smash. Especially on a platform. Nice nair. Again, that could have been an up smash, though. This whiff punish right here, look at this. He falls through the side platform. Very easy prediction. Like, everybody always does aerial into immediate aerial. Usually it's like a shield drop. This guy just did back air to back air. That's an up smash, and then just turn that into a 90% with an edge guard combo. Like, that's what Leffen would have done, right? Nice, nice, nice. Not the worst thing in the world. The thing is, with you standing right here, if you stand from here on at the ledge, I want to say right there, it means that you're at execution testing them. Like, if he ledge dashes you right here, if he does this down air from the ledge, if he does some tight double lasers, sometimes it's going to be harder to punish. But it's like you want him to mess up. You want him to do like a high aerial or something. You want him to do double lasers so that you can shine him. And so something that you're going to have to do as players get better is back up and stay in this space a little bit more often and then punish them off the ledge. But even I get execution tested and die. But even maybe think about like full hopping a little bit more instead of being grounded when you're next to someone on the ledge like this. You got there a little bit slow too. Just make sure that you're not hesitating with little things like this full hop double jump for no real reason. Nice. Very good ledge grab. So that was a lot more solid. We saw the platforms come into play quite a bit more. You closed out a couple edge guards. This shows you just how much converting matters. Like, you closed out two solid edge guards, and now you two-stock him, right? And all the other times on the last game, it's like you just could not convert those up throws into kills. You'd get a launcher off stage, but you wouldn't complete the edge guard. You were a lot cleaner off the ledge here, too. It was really nice. You hit a couple really good ledge dashes. Yeah, I like quite a bit of what I was seeing. I still would like to see you power stealing quite a bit more lasers, although he didn't shoot a ton on this stage. Power stealing the lasers, also doing take laser turnaround up tilt, it's just so effective, dude. You just have to do it. Like I said, watch Crush, Leffen, and KJH, and you'll just see how to deal with those lasers, man. It's so good. And then run up smash could have helped you so much this match. Okay. So we're going to go to game three. Pokemon Stadium, I agree, you probably banned Battlefield. Let me just take one bite of this real quick. I know it's going to be in the video, but God, I'm hungry. Alright, here we go. Back to it. So here we are, Pokemon Stadium. I like to position myself on the side platform at the beginning of matches when I'm the Fox, because it's really hard for Falco to pressure the side platforms effectively. Nice attempt at the full hop nair in, but it was a little predictable. And at the spacing, so if you full hop from right here, just listen to me for a sec. This is really important. So if you're jumping at him at all from right here, where you jumped from, it is going to be a full hop. Otherwise, your short hop, look at what my mouse is doing. Your short hop goes from here to here, right? Which literally cannot hit him. So he has no fear of a short hop coming at all. So this has to be a full hop or else it's not effective. So that is the only thing he's looking for, which is why he does this little dash back right here, right? So just make sure you're paying attention to the ranges that you're attacking from. Because this isn't a mix-up. This is your only option from that spacing. So try to intelligently take space a little bit more often, right? What I mean by that is maybe power shield that laser, wave dash forward. Maybe take the laser, dash forward, then do the full hop from right here instead so that you're getting all the way over here and so that your short hop would actually connect with him at that spacing. All those little things matter so much. So just pay attention, because that's the only mix-up that you had. You couldn't have hit him with a running shine. You couldn't have hit him with a running up smash. Only full hop would have reached him from right there. And since you jumped, it was just so incredibly obvious. Scramble situation. Not a lot to say about that right there. Power shield on the laser, but no real conversion. A lot of this is just so scrambled. You guys aren't forcing real mix-ups. You're just like spot dodging and rolling and just... Yeah, roll, shield, roll. Short hop, nair, spot dodge, short hop, nair, spot dodge. Short hop, nair. Just try to set up more spaces where you feel comfortable attacking from, right? Like, I feel like you guys are just trying to attack each other whenever you can. And it's like, well, be a little bit more patient. Try to wait for your opponent to hang themselves. If he shoots you with a laser, go to the side platform, right? What's he going to do when you're on the side platform? Try to force the mix-ups from the side platform. Run off aerial, short hop off aerial, drop through, dash forward, right? There's a million things that you can do. But instead you guys are just kind of rolling, and then he dash attacks, and then you nair, and then he spot dodges, then you roll, and then he does that. It's like, all of this is just kind of silly. See, immediate short hop nair, immediately full hop back air. And now, see, we're backed up a little bit. What happens? You go to side platform. This is great. This is exactly what I wanted to see. You go side platform. You full hop on the side platform, though. What was this going to accomplish? You always want to make sure everything you do has a purpose. This is nothing. It's only going to get hit by those lasers. I don't know why he shot those lasers either, unless he thought that you were going to full hop, which is just the weirdest thing in the world. So weird. If he shoots these full hop lasers, by the way, what you should do in response, you should be standing here and reacting. If he does this, take center stage and get under him. It's really, really good. Another missed power shield. You're hanging out on side platform. You take center stage from him. I don't mind this at all. Except what I do mind is this. Look, you got back on the ground, and then you shield for no reason. Right? He didn't dash forward. You shield, and then you full hop double jump again. Wave dash out of shield. Please. Wave dash out of shield. I don't mind the full hop off the... I would have preferred it be a short hop off this side platform. Bam, then you could threaten that back air. That's okay, you whiff punishes, you kind of look like you missed your L cancel. Yeah, so he just messed up his edge guard, and you did the early side B, and then you pressured him in the corner with the full hop nair. You randomly double jumped. A lot of this is just scramble situations. Like, when you have him in the corner like this, like, look. First of all, his edge guard was atrocious. But when you are right here, this grab, meaningless, you didn't react correctly, right? His spot dodge probably would have dodged if you tried to do the run-up grab right there and you were a little bit too slow. He full hop double jumps for seemingly no reason. The full hop nair into the corner is pretty good, but it can lose to roll. So you just kind of have to keep that in mind. Just like, think about waiting a little bit more often and seeing what they do. Because imagine if he full hop double jumps right here, which is what his original plan was. You just stay here with your back turned, and you can easily back air anything he has coming down. Even his down air, it just out prioritizes it. And then he's dead, because he has no double jump. So sometimes wait for your opponent and let them hang themselves, especially when they're in the corner, because they have to make something happen. And also, the risk of them doing anything is so much larger when they're in the corner. I like the full hops. Again, all these like light shields and rolls, not amazing. Not the best edge guard, but I don't mind the back throw shine attempt, especially at such a low percent when he already threw himself into the corner. This is exactly what I was talking about again. Just look at this. So you get a knockdown, drill shine. This is the exact same scenario we saw before at the beginning of the match. Why are you giving up this space? These lasers don't actually accomplish anything for you. Falco dies off one hit right here. You can't be scared because you're at high percent, right? He needs to hit a clean hit off of you out of the corner somehow. I don't know how he's going to do it. And if you tap him with a nair, if you hit him with a running shine, if you run up grab forward throw, all of those things have a very high percent chance of just him just dying straight up in the corner right here. If you up smash him, he DIs out. And then you set up for like a full hop back air. Be amazing. But you back all the way off. You have to be threatening at all times, especially when Falco is in the corner. Do not give up that space. More full hop nairs into the corner. It's not bad. It's not a bad option, for sure. But he shot a laser in the wrong direction. You didn't clean up the edge guard correctly. Could have up-tilted after that to convert a little harder. I'm going through it so quickly because, like, well, yeah, you could have up-tilted, but when you side-B somebody, are you not going to up-tilt the next time or something? Like, I don't know how to explain that so that it would help in the future, you know what I mean? But just look for all of the opportunities that you have and just try to convert a little bit harder. Demand that much more out of yourself, out of every single punish, out of every single interaction. So this full hop double jump nair right here is just kind of... It doesn't look like you know what to do when Falco's on the ledge. I would stand still with my back turn. Short hop back air and up tilt are amazing corner pressure tools. And then the full hop nair is kind of like a mix-up. Full hop nair seems to be kind of like the thing that you do. Again, the shielding. It should be so hard to pin you down. But instead, like, you kind of just go in and shield. You didn't even, like, dash in shield right here. If you dashed in and, like, met him right here with the shield, that would be an early nair, and you just up smash, grab him out of shield. Be great. Instead, he sets up a little bit of pressure on you. See, you get hit by the laser, immediate shield, and then what do you do out of the shield? Roll back, full hop? Okay. Wave dash out of shield would have been so much nicer to keep the pace going. All of this has to do with tempo. Like, if you just kept the pace going with a wave dash forward out of shield, could have threatened so much more. It seems like you're on the back foot consistently because you're not dealing with these lasers correctly. Go to the side platforms if you feel like you're really that flustered on the ground. Instead of just doing all these just take laser shields and like attempted power shields. Also, get in the lab a little bit and power shield lasers. You're going for so many that I feel like you want it to be effective, but you're hitting so little that it's not effective at all. This is you not attacking from the correct threat range. Again, this nair. You were expecting him to move forward, but he's just waiting in the corner. Which is okay. Throwing out zoning moves right there is fine, but just like a full nair into the corner will allow you to be whiff punished. Things like a short hop back air that fades into center stage are a little bit more effective. So again, these full hops, like I was talking about, just kind of straight up lose to roll. Watch this. You see he rolls, takes center stage, and now you're in the corner. So you want to be a little careful with how much you're full hopping into the corner, exactly how I was talking about before. If you're doing more back airs, short hop back airs, it's a lot better for you. Watch out for this. Look. So you roll here and then you dash back. Now you're all the way here and he's all the way here. Remember those threat ranges we were talking about? You want to be able to hit him with at all times. You want him to think, oh shit, I'm in the corner. I could die. When you go right here, his subconscious, not even him consciously, his subconscious is saying, Oh, look at this fox. Gave me a bunch of space. Immediate, take laser shield again. Please, dear God. The way you're dealing with lasers is most definitely the thing that you need to work on the most. And then, unfortunate, you try to do another early side B. He didn't kill you. A little bit of a flub there. Grab the ledge. No, down smash. Okay. Two stocks to two. Transformation. Transformations are so hard for me to navigate, especially in analysis. I don't know what you want me to tell you. These platforms are at super weird heights. You gotta stop, like, shielding after taking these lasers, dude. You gotta. Look, dash, like, full hop right after this. Go to this platform. What's he gonna do? Dash forward right here. Threaten him. If you dash forward after taking this laser right here, even if he shoots a laser fast as he possibly can, you'll end up being right here. And now you're at a range where you can threaten him. Even after the second laser, you can dash in up smash. You can dash back. You can turn around up tilt. You're in a space where that's threatening. So dash forward after taking this laser. Don't just shield like this all the time. Because then you're just in this pressure, right? You feel like you're forced to roll because you're not wave dashing out of shield. You're not using the platforms correctly. So if you're going to shield, you have to be ready to wave dash. Please wave dash. Please stop doing this. I really hope that this makes sense to you and that helps you, because you are rolling and full hop double jumping all over the place when you should be wave dashing out of shield or just not shielding at all. A very lucky grab. Extremely lucky. And then he just completely messes up. Big yikes. You go to ledge. I love it. Love it, love it. You did that last time too, and he didn't punish you for it. I'm surprised he didn't punish you directly for it again that time. Early side B again, exactly what I was talking about. Try to sweet spot those. Fox has a decently easy time sweet spotting his side Bs. So try to do it a little bit more often. A Falco shooting lasers on the stage, by the way, cannot hit you if you're trying to sweet spot the side B. So you weren't really in threat of anything at that moment if you tried to sweet spot that side B. Okay, he gets kind of a lucky shine out of a scramble situation. Short hop nair into the corner. Don't cover his roll. You get a power shield, but you're way too far away. Some flubs. There was almost a take laser dash forward. It was like kind of unintentional, it looked like. I love the up tilt finally. So you have him in the corner. Look, he overcommits into the corner. You're right here. Up tilt. I love it. I want to see more of that. Stop short hop nairing into the corner so much. Like right here. Look at this. Stop right here, wave dash down, and then either turn around up tilt or back air. Do a short hop back air or a full hop back air, land on the side platform. He can't hit you with anything meaningful if you do that. And then you're always threatening, pushing him back into the corner. That short hop nair is like the instant gratification, like, aha, I caught you lasering, you're dead. The other thing is the very consistent short hop back air that's going to keep him in the corner. So let's see, how do you get opened up right here? Again, out of shield, you're just doing these full hop double jumps, dude. And you're not even ever drifting back. You're always drifting in. Jeepers creepers. That's going to be the death of you, dude. Yeah. That's all it was, dude. Oh, my goodness. I swear to God. It's because that was so close. If you just wave dashed out of shield. Literally, if you just wave dashed out of shield. I'm willing to say that you would have won that set 2-0. Maybe not with the FD start. But if you guys only played the matches, games 2 and 3, it would have been a fat 2-0. Even if you just waved dash out of shield. Not to mention all of the other things that you could have been doing. So I really hope that that helped. Really dealing with lasers was like the main thing that you really need to work on. Just keep in mind, again, I'm going to list it out for you. Write them down if you want. Anybody watching, write them down. Take laser, dash forward, and after dashing forward, you can either nair or up smash. So those are the two main ones that you should do, or a running shine. Turn around up tilt, full hop, or dash back, right? This is what you want to do. Or shield, take laser, shield is good sometimes against Falcos who are doing laser into early aerial a lot. This Falco is not really doing that. So just consider those are your options against that, or hit your power shields. It seems like you really want to power shield the lasers, but you are so inconsistent at it that it just wasn't effective. Other than that, stop doing early side B so high. Sweet spot those side Bs and be more comfortable with yourself on the ledge. After your ledge dash, do ledge dash up smash, ledge dash nair, ledge dash full hop, ledge dash dash back. Did I say up smash? Jab. All those things are good. You're doing ledge dash shield or ledge dash roll every single time you're off the ledge. And then run up smash way more in neutral, way more in neutral. Watch Leffen, Kalindi, and by Kalindi I mean KJH, and Crush. Watch them against Falco and just see the effective tools that they use in the matchup. It's so good. So I hope that helped. To anybody watching, I hope that it helped you. And I'll see you guys around next time. Peace.